Hey there, folks. Welcome back. So I gotta ask you, why are you tormenting yourselves? Why are you tormenting yourselves over the Oscars? Now, it ended a couple of days ago. I know I'm a little late to the party here as far as talking about the Oscars is concerned, but people never cease to be angry or upset or frustrated over the Oscars. There's always going to be something in there that's going to piss them off. And my point is, if you dislike it so much, why are you watching it? Why feed into that at all? You knew that they weren't going to mention people who deserve to be mentioned, like Sid Haig or Tim Conway. Those are the two big ones right now. Who Sid Haig, funny enough, the thing I remember Sid Haig mostly for was Jason of Star Command. Who remembers that show? Jason of Star Command, a Saturday morning live action TV show on CBS. He had the best maniacal laugh in the business, I swear. And Tim Conway, who was a comedic actor giant in his day, both passed away, weren't mentioned. A lot of people are upset about that. Or people being put on a pedestal who don't necessarily deserve to be on a pedestal, like Jane Fonda. A lot of people angry about Jane Fonda and her standing ovation and all of the praise that she received because they have not forgotten still what she did during the Vietnam War. And some of you younger people probably have no idea what I'm talking about. Look up the phrase Hanoi Jane, which I probably just lost all of my ad revenue for the day for even saying that on YouTube. Look it up and you'll see what I'm talking about. From a celebrity perspective, Hollywood loves her, but in the real world, there's not very much love for Jane Fonda. So, whatever. You knew people were going to get Oscars who didn't deserve it. Like, what's that film? American Factory, Best Documentary Feature. And the only reason American Factory got an Oscar is because it's from Barack and Michelle Obama's production company. Actually, I got it written down here. It says, American Factory, the first title from Barack and Michelle Obama's production company, the first title, Higher Ground is the name of the production company, won the Academy Award for Best Documentary Feature on Sunday, solidifying the Obamas' status as budding media moguls. They wanted to hand them an award, and they did. I mean, Michelle just won a Grammy. Does this surprise anyone? You knew people who didn't deserve it. We're going to get it. Now, Joaquin Phoenix got Best Actor, but he couldn't not because too many people would have been upset if he didn't. But people get awards that don't deserve them. You knew the Oscars was going to be long and boring because it's been long and boring since at least the 1970s. It's been a long, boring production for decades and decades. Didn't start out that way. The original Oscars only took like half an hour. You knew that it was going to have political and or social overtones because that's how it's been getting handled for the last 20 years at least. Ack, I mean, really, who remembers Bill the Cat? Bill the Cat and Opus. Who remembers them? You knew that the Oscars was going to have social and political agendas. You knew people who didn't deserve awards were going to get them. You knew people who did deserve it weren't. You knew people who didn't deserve attention were going to get it. You knew that people that should have been mentioned weren't going to be. So if you hate it so much, why do you torment yourselves? Why do you watch it? If you want this to go away forever, you need to stop paying attention to it. I know there's going to be plenty of people who are going to comment and say, I didn't watch. Good. Good, because there's nothing to see. There's nothing to see with any of these award ceremonies. Watching these people pat each other on the back and give away awards to each other. And this has happened to all of these. It's not just the Academy Awards, it's the Emmys, it's the Country Music Awards, the Nobel Peace Prize. The Nobel Peace Prize. I was frustrated. I learned that lesson when Al Gore won a Nobel Prize. The woman, because of who he beat that year, you need to look that up. the woman that he beat, who was a Nazi survivor. She was a survivor who smuggled children across the border to rescue them under her skirt and in suitcases in any way she could, thousands of children, and was captured and tortured and never talked. Irina Sendler. Irina Sendler, that was her name. This is, she saved thousands of children. She was kidnapped, tortured, never talked, rescued from a POW camp. She got beat by Al Gore for his video on global warming that wasn't even accurate. They just wanted to give Al Gore an award. This woman actually did something and couldn't get recognized. And that was my wake-up call to that fact that absolutely all of these awards now are politically and socially driven. People don't really earn them anymore. So why do you do it? If you're still watching these shows and they make you upset, stop watching them. The only way they're really ever going to go away or change is if people stop paying attention to them. And there is a negative attention factor that ties in with this, which is something I've been asked to do a video on before. You know what? I think we're going to do that video next. So the next video, I'm going to talk about this because there is a negative attention factor that ties in with that, whereby a lot of times people pay attention to things because they hate them. But anyway, tell me what you think. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section down below. Please do give the video a thumbs up if you get where I'm coming from. Share it if you can. Subscribe if you're new. All that good stuff. If you don't mind, if there's an ad, please do let it run. You don't have to pay attention to it for it to count. It doesn't amount to much, but it's something, and every little bit counts. If you heard any weird noises while we're sitting here, it's because I've got a cat knocked out on my desk. I'll put a picture up of him because he looks ridiculous right now with his tongue hanging out. Anyways, if you wanted to help the channel out further, there are links for that down below, and I really do appreciate it. It doesn't happen often, but it means a lot. So what more can I say? But stay tuned, folks, because there is more to come.